Hello again.
So we got all our ingredients done yesterday. Cut up a little too much onion. Today I'm gonna be cooking them. Stream was the picking of the chicken off of the bone. Start with the Italian sausage because we're going to do that in a separate pan. I think I'm going to do 4 links. Now, yesterday I was thinking of going to buy some regular sausage, so we're just going to go with the Italian sausage because I think we can make it work. And it's the most widely available sausage in the world. You can make it work with Italian sausage one time. You can make this anywhere. You know what? Let's use all the sausage. Why not? The internet said that the best way to do this. Put the sausage on, on a slow simmer. To let the water cook off. This is one of the most common stove designs you find in America. For probably 20 to 30 years. So they're everywhere, you know. Some of them don't have the knobs on top, but most of them do, I think. Okay. So... Seems like a lot. We're gonna go with a half cup, I think. I think that'll be appropriate. Wow, almost done flour. Shit. Well, good thing I'm not making too much since I'm using up the rest of my flour here. You know what? We're just gonna estimate. Amount of flour and oil. Start with this amount. See where that gets us. This is taking a while on the right side. This is going to take a while too, though. This is unbleached flour, so that's why it looks a little bit less blonde immediately. Good. All right. It's 10:45. It is 3 minutes off. Sausage is certainly wet. Basically, toasting the flour in oil, or frying the flour, maybe. That's what a roux is. It's gonna take a while. because there's not much material. Absorbs heat pretty quick. This, on the other hand, maybe I should turn it up a little bit. All right. Whoever used this pot last didn't do a good job of cleaning it after. That's okay. Maybe there's too much water in this sausage. Hold on a second. It's at a half inch, but it's like a quarter inch might be better. Or maybe that's closer to it. This fire might be too hot on this side. Nah, probably not actually. We want it to be some amount pretty hot because, well, reasonably hot because you don't want to, you want it to take forever to do the room. Will take quite some time now. This would want it to be a nice brown dark. This seems like it's coming up to a center here. I expect the sausages to be done before the roux. But I really don't know how long it's going to take. I don't make Italian sausage very often. I know the roux is going to take some time. Wish I had my... Maybe I should have just cleaned my old clad pan instead of getting out this new pan. You know what? That probably would have been better. Oh well. Or this new pot. I did the turkey broth in another pot. It's a little bit wider and shorter. Don't don't really know how much this is going to make, but it's probably going to be quite a bit. Check here. Nothing of value. Is there like a button I can just clear all my notifications at once? There we go. That'll be helpful. You guys don't have round doorknobs? Why? Round is the most accessible shape for people to grab with their hands. What if you don't have fingers? I'm just messing around. Okay. So this is starting to get where we want it to be. Should smell good. I mean, I guess that's pretty normal. What's really a pain is if you make a roux and like one of those big gumbo pots where you're doing like this, your arm gets tired so quick. It's probably not the way to go. Just make the roux on like a side pan and then pour it into the big pot. But I have done it that way before. That gumbo came out really good too. That wasn't my gumbo though, that was my dad's gumbo. Okay, so that's simmering, whatever. It's gotta get up to 160 degrees to be safe. Because it's raw pork. I don't cook a lot with raw sausage. It's usually some form of already cooked smoked sausage. You're more heating it up and adding its flavors to other things. Background overlapping the time. I mean that wall, it's all covered with shit. Yeah. Might be a slightly too much amount of oil in here, but that's okay. It's gonna be fine. We're adding a lot of stuff like the sausages are getting to a good spot. They're simmering slowly. Which is what we want. Probably do that until 11. Take the cover off and wait for the water to evaporate. All right. Just adjusting some stuff here. Could probably take all the plastic off of these vegetables. Well, it certainly smells like Italian sausage. Fennel. Out a way where you can like melt down all your plastic wrap and run it through a machine that like prints out more plastic wrap. That would reduce a ton of, or that would recycle . Maybe I should take the lid off now, actually. Yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna take the lid off now and let the water kind of drip off. What is this stuff here? What's that? That fat from the sausage? Casing? It's not casing. I don't know. Well, whatever. Still pretty far from where we need to be on the roof. If I had some more flour, I'd add just a tad bit more to this, but that's okay. Fine. Probably turn these over or something, huh? So they're not getting the majority of the heat all on one side. I mean, it's possible that Sweden offloads its meat production onto Finland for a variety of reasons. Probably more open land. Probably. Probably so they can focus their industry on something, you know, specialization. Industry specialization is always pretty good. I think I'm gonna have to pour this water out for these sausages. It's gonna take forever for this water to boil out. I'm just gonna pour some off. Okay, we'll keep in a smaller amount. Probably shouldn't be using this fork, but it's fine. Doesn't take long for this flour to get a lot of heat incorporated into it pretty quickly. That's why you gotta keep moving it around. I mean, you want it to toast, but you want it to toast, you know, slowly enough that it doesn't burn. Hello, Dr. Sandman. Construction on the tracks. trains and shit. I used to park my car in near downtown Portland, right next to the train tracks. And sometimes the train would just take so long. Because it was like, it was also like a loading and unloading, like, dock area type thing. One time the train was so stopped on the tracks, I considered just jumping on the train and crossing. But I didn't want to get wrecked, you know? I didn't want to fuck around and find out. It got moving again pretty quickly. Like 5 minutes. Fuck. All this kitchen stuff is fucking with my back. It's starting to get darker. We got a ways to go yet, though. I'm glad that the Italian sausage didn't explode. I hope it, like, stays in a pretty good form for cutting it to slice it. Damn. My kitchen is clean? It's not that clean, but it'll do. My roommate's girlfriend, she does most of the cooking and managing the kitchen and all that stuff, so all props to her, I suppose. I try to keep stuff clean some amount. I don't know how I'm gonna cut these sausages. They're gonna be hot as fuck. I guess I might have to let them rest. They don't come in until after the vegetables have been cooked off and stuff too, though. So I should have some amount of time. Starting to get to more of a, I don't know, maybe peanut butter color here. Maybe a little before peanut butter. It's a little bit harder to tell with the unbleached flour. Ow, fuck. I mean, it's certainly in a better, place than it was at previous times, for sure. I've kind of tried to be a little bit more diligent about cleaning and stuff as well. So I'm pretty sure I'm going to have like a... red spot where I touched my pinky to the side of the pan. Like, I should probably put it in some water, but that's okay. It'll be fine. Just a light burn, not a major burn. Probably won't blister. Probably could use some cooling though. I love these things. These silicon, like, spatula things are awesome. As you can see, I'm not left-handed. Yeah, the human body is basically just a big thermal power plant. We distribute and disperse heat. And that's why things like wireless and 5G doesn't hurt us. Because even though the wireless and the 5G cause heat to enter our bodies, our body just redistributes them. Redistributes the heat. So hot. Okay, let's see. So water is mostly going off the sausage. We're trying to get some browning on the outside of these sausages. Might take a little while. I like that I can see the color change every time I set down this spatula. I can see it, like where it used to be, where it is. It's getting closer. Not quite there yet. Getting closer, though. This is around where I stopped it last time I made gumbo, but I really think it's better to go all the way to a deep, dark, almost chocolatey type darkness. Okay, now the sausages are starting to sizzle a little bit, so they should start getting some browning on the outside. Definitely want them to be browned on the outside, not just boiled sausage or steamed. I don't know what you call it. What you do to sausage. I guess boiling. Oh yeah, beautiful aroma. Let's see. That's what I'm talking about right there.
God, this ship's gonna be so fucking good.
I suppose that could happen if you don't ever work with any tools ever. Just toasted flour, but goddamn, it's so good.
Who's a good little girl?
No, I don't have anything for you to try just yet. Still not much browning on the sausages. Ow, what the goddamn fucking tiny little stove. This one's got a little bit of brown on it. There's plenty of oil in this pan. Sausages start to release some oil so they don't get stuck to the bottom of the pan. Until I started playing music. I suppose I could just listen to music though, since it's not like I'm doing anything else, and you guys can't hear the music, so. Fuck it. It's a playlist I was listening to yesterday in the shower. It's like 80s music. Currently, Take On Me, one of Poe's favorites.
Fuck, man.
Ah, shit, is it getting over? Well, maybe not burnt, but pretty dark on one side. Ah, so it's no annoying here. They're nice and stiff, so that's good. Oh yeah. Oh, I should really have my hair up, huh? Damn. God, these are both hitting critical points near the same time. I wish there was a little oil in here. I guess this is probably browned enough for the sausages, I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna say this is good for the sausages. Cool off and then cut them up. Oh no, I've got to keep on moving. Break my stride. Oh shit. Okay, that can't fit there. That could have been bad. Yeah, you smelling that, huh, girl? Smelling real good. This music's kind of distracting me. Alright, I think what I'm gonna do is go from here. I'm gonna do how much
Majority of these onions. Celery. All this bell pepper. Okay. Keep one to grab this thing. Most of them will break up. I may have to break up some of them myself. Okay, so now we're gonna sweat the vegetables. I don't have to pay near as much attention for this. Okay, whew. I think normally I would do a finer dice. Probably. We'll see. We'll see how it turns out. Pretty tasty. Fennel or anise flavors. fact that it has more spice probably means I'll just use less. Maybe more black pepper in the front would help with the fennel. In front of the taste, but not of the tongue. Another black pepper tends to brown it more in the pan, but thinking that's probably unnecessary. How's the vegetables coming here? Looking for a little bit more translucency on these onions. Spice component later as well. Just a little bit more. I keep almost grabbing that. I'm glad I'm subconsciously stopping myself from grabbing it. Let me put the rest of these fucking onions back in the fridge. I don't know what the fucking thing is that for. Probably something with chicken. Since I have that airline chicken. Okay. And I have carrots. Here's our cut-up sausage. We'll use that later. I'm leaving them in whole pieces this time. Could have done halves, but I did feel more comfortable doing that when it's like... already cooked sausage. Okay, cool enough.
Soap.
Should help with all the sausage bits that got stuck. The bottom. Okay, I think we're pretty much at where we want to be here. The vegetables.
So this wants me to add garlic and black pepper before I add the stock.
Just a bit more black pepper.
And we're going to do a very light amount of cayenne. Light sprinkle for now. Do the garlic.
Do a fair amount.
Yeah, not too much, but a reasonable amount.
Incorporate all that.
There.
Chicken stock.
Oh yeah.
I guess we do want all this stuff at the bottom here. What? Just little bits of chicken and bay leaf and parsley. That was maybe a quart and a half of chicken stock, maybe 2 quarts.
We bring the flavor. That all came from our process yesterday. So we get to see it reheat. We get to see all that effort pay off. So now I think we want to turn up the heat. And get us to get us to kind of a simmer. And start tasting. Let's see where we're at right now with in terms of flavor. This isn't gonna work for this, is it? Tastes good. Definitely needs salt, time to develop. Once we get this kind of more up, we're going to be cooking it for about an hour. And then we're going to cook it for another hour after we add the chicken and sausage. It looks like if you were using filet, you'd add the filet at the end. Because you don't want it to simmer. Pads are good computers, man. Okay. Oh, I need to make rice. Oh, shit. That'd be would be using white rice, but it seems I only have this brown rice, so let me use that. Actually, this is way too soon to be starting this race, so I'm just gonna not start it. We can add some water if we find that it's getting too thick, but I don't think we will. What the heck is that? Did that come off the side of the pot? I don't know how cleaning two kitchen devices is considered a lazy dinner.
You guys can't hear that music, right? I'm gonna listen to something else.
buy some flour.
What's up?
Oh, sorry, I was... there was some stuff on my phone.
You could hear the music? Hopefully not.
Oh, barely. Oh, okay. You can hear it through the... Can you hear the... You can hear it, like, through the Bluetooth headphone, because it's playing in the Bluetooth headphone, but then it's, my microphone is in the Bluetooth headphone as well.
I think the room got dark enough. I'm not sure.
Rice cooker is definitely worth it. I disagree with this. It's easier than a toaster for rice, because toasters have different settings. You don't even have to set anything. You just turn it on. Where's the perfect toast machine? How come they never figured that one out? Yeah, mine doesn't even have buttons on it. Mine just has on and off. It's literally just cook the rice or be done cooking the rice. or haven't started cooking the rice yet.
There's a lot of good flavor in there.
I think it definitely needs more salt and more pepper, but I think I'm gonna let it cook down before I do any of that. I would say that in order to make that rice cooker, you would have to modify the equipment, or basically break the thing. Because it can't produce awful rice. It's scientifically impossible. You'd have to, like, abuse your rice cooker, basically. The only reason I would add, water to this. Oh, you're talking about. Okay. You're talking about rice. Never mind. I guess I'll do dishes.
I don't have anything else going on.
This is maybe simmering higher than I would like. Thank you.
guys like washing dishes ASMR.
I love C sharp. Now, the only problem is this is spicy Italian sausage. I'm thinking it might be even harder with the non-spicy Italian sausage. And I don't know if the spicy Italian sausage is going to be available. I wish I could fast forward through this. Thank you. Okay. Jesus. Washing the dishes does such a number on my back. I'll probably speed up this part. Oh my god. Yes. Yes. Oh my god, the depth of flavor already. So good. I would challenge. Well. I would challenge anyone who believes they could follow along with this previous video and this video and not get the same result. I bet you could make some really good food. Lily. There isn't zero orca here. Did I use orca? I don't think I used anything that was unusual. Maybe the hot Italian sausage. Thank you.
guess I'll have like a bowl of ice cream. I mean, that's kind of the only other thing I have to eat in the house right now. That's like ready to eat. Backwards eat dessert before lunch situation here. Or dessert before lunch slash dinner. I don't know, I'm just really hungry. I haven't eaten anything all day. Fucking just been, you know, basically, making. I didn't like. I was gonna find something to eat for dinner last night, but instead of finding something to eat, I just ate. I just drank a Soylent, and that was my last Soylent. Would think it was so American because it uses artificial food coloring to look green. It's also very sweet. I mean, it's ice cream, so kind of supposed to be. I hope you guys can hear me eating this ice cream. Oh. Well, you know, I don't know what to say.
It's delicious.
Hey, you could look at it.
I told you it was very American.
You want me to get off stream later so you can share? I'm okay with that. That show pretty much done. I showed you guys the majority of the cooking process. The only thing left here is this is going to simmer down for another 30 minutes or so. Then we add this, the meat. Possibly more water if it's too thick, you know. And then it simmers for another hour. At this point, though, you can adjust some of the flavors. But you have to keep in consideration that the flavors that these things are going to add. The chicken's probably not going to add much flavor. It's more bulk. It does have a lot of that, you know, broth flavor to it, so it should marry nicely with what's already in there. But you're mostly seasoning the chicken after it's in, because it's going to absorb a lot of the, you know, the spiciness and stuff that's in the broth. This is going to distribute some additional fat and some spiciness into the broth. So it should all just kind of start to meld together and build in flavors. After you do that, you just simmer for another hour. You can adjust the flavor as soon as you put them in. So you can get some of those flavors simmering at the same time for another hour. But really, you're probably going to want to not season it so much until towards the end of the hour. You're going to want to taste what that tastes like, and then, you know, this or that. I'm gonna let it go, though, because, you know, I just wanted to explain what's going to happen over the next hour or so. Oh, yeah. I haven't even added the meat yet, and I gotta wait for another 15-20 minutes.
Smells good.
What's that?
Smells good.
Yeah, it's gonna get better when the sausage and the chicken are in there. And get some more spices. That's the hope, anyway.
Thank you.
You know, I probably shouldn't have pulled out the chicken and sausage so soon. They probably should be in the fridge. It's going to be fine, but I don't know.
Giving this a stir every once in a while. You know, make sure we're getting good consistency throughout. Want the heat to be, you know, evenly distributed. Fuck, Jesus. Almost lost one of my fucking earbuds. I don't know which earbud does the microphone. Let's see, I just saw you pour in celery and something else. No, okay, so no. The vegetables that we used are... The vegetables that we used are just the trio, which is celery, bell pepper, and onion. I probably should have bought some scallions while I was at the store. Oh well. Why can you not have meat in the pot at this time? So what you're doing here is you're layering flavors. So, yeah. You know what? This is too low. I'm going back to 3 minutes. So you're layering flavors. So right now we're kind of extracting the flavors from the onions and the celery and the bell pepper, you know, and kind of incorporating that all into the broth before we incorporate this into the broth, because then it won't be as muddled, right? I mean, you're kind of, you know, you're building more of a, you know, trying to think of something that is built like that. It's like you're making a lasagna, right? Yeah. you want different parts of the flavor to express themselves at different times in the bite, I guess. I don't know. It's just the way you do it. I would like to be able to explain it as well as someone who went to culinary school, but I cannot. All I know is, for generations in Louisiana, they've been making food this way. We're going to keep it simmering for another, you know, hour and 10 minutes, maybe. But we're gonna add all this stuff in the next maybe 10-20 minutes. Yeah, but you're pro denuclearization. God damn. Typical of saying some stupid shit.
Have a good night. Later. Not even the scout will stop her.
Dude, this chicken stuff from yesterday was awesome. It's gonna taste so good.
Okay.
Civil War.
Oh my god.
I think we're ready. It's tasting pretty much just where I want it. It's got a nice vegetable flavor that's bolstered by the broth and the spices that we put in already. We're gonna see how this changes it. We're gonna see how this changes the flavor over the next 30 minutes or so. Bone in there. Shit. I think I might have missed a bone. Ah, that's okay. Let's see if there's a... There is... bone, I think. Ow. Just pull this on the side here. Ow, fuck. I don't think there's a bone. It was just a big chunk of meat. Okay, well, whatever. Rather it be broken up.
this argument that Tinsley just made. This is stupid. Holy fuck. So,
get some lunch. Probably eat the gumbo for dinner, if that's cool.
Yeah, I mean, that was the plan anyways. It was a dinner meal. Yoko, shut up. I mean, I'm definitely having a bowl of this for lunch. It's going to be a late lunch, that's why I had that bowl of ice cream, but... one of them's name is Yoko, and she's a little piece of shit. The other one is my dog, named Lily.
a little dog, man. I wish my roommate would stop taking it. Of course, he actually wants to take it, so...
I think some of the chicken skin will break down, but I think eventually you just want to pull that stuff out of there. Seems like the sausage is holding together pretty well, which is one thing that I wanted to see, I wasn't sure about. Lower that just a degree.
Okay.
Now we're going to have to deal with adjusting the flavor for the fennel sausage, for sure. Let's see where we're at. It's got a decent back of your throat heat from the sausage. I'm definitely tasting the fennel.
Say more garlic or onion. Maybe like a lemon juice. I don't know. No, I don't see how that would work. Maybe some bitterness? I don't think I have any, like, lemon or anything. Maybe some vinegar? Rice vinegar? Yes. I think that was a good choice. I didn't put much vinegar in. Just a couple splashes. Yes. I think that worked. Holy shit. I can't believe that worked. I think it did. So the fennel has like a very particular type flavor. From the sausage, and it seems like the vinegar was able to counteract that flavor. Actually worked out quite well. Maybe it just helped marry the flavor better. It's hard to say exactly what it did, but I think with that little bit of vinegar, it tastes much more cohesive, as like it's not a separate part of the flavor anymore. It's kind of combined. Get rid of this chicken skin. I mean, you probably don't have to pull out the chicken skin. You can probably eat it. It's just, I don't know. Why eat it? It's just gooey, slimy thing.
bad texture here. See the thickness though of the stock already, you know? It really probably doesn't need a thickener like filet or okra. I mean, people do use a thickener often, but it, like, does it need a thickener? Not really. I mean, as long as you're able to kind of bathe your rice and have, like, a bite of, you know, all of the ingredients in here plus rice, you know, with plenty of the broth on your spoon. I mean, you know. I just don't know if it needs to be that thick, you know. It seems like a little bit of it seems like the sourness counteracted the sweetness of the fennel. Seems like that's what happened. I'm looking at Le Cordon Bleu article on how to balance the five flavors. I bet some bitterness would have helped too, but I think that the sourness actually just worked just fine. And I only needed to add just a little bit, so I think we're good. The sourness from the vinegar. So I could probably do something like that in Scandinavia, in Sweden, or in Denmark. I can probably get like a sweet sausage, like an Italian sausage, and then counteract it with some vinegar. And add some heat instead of using the already hot Italian sausage. Just add some cayenne and some you know what? I think I'm gonna add some paprika, actually. I think I did that last time and it was good. And some chili powder too. Now that I think about it. Soft chili powder. I'm starting to think about the flavor, the end flavor. I want a good amount of paprika. That's probably good. And a smallish amount of chili powder. Well, maybe, yeah, something like that. Oh my god. Yes, this is looking perfect, boys. Oh my god, yes. Alright. We'll let those flavors develop, and then we'll come back and taste it again. now I'm kind of building towards the end result of the flavor. So I wanted to, I want to kind of combine a little bit, taste it, feel the flavors that I'm looking for, and then maybe add something else, give it a little bit of time to combine, taste again. I probably won't have to modify the flavors too much from where they are. But I'm just gonna kind of keep tasting and taste and see where it reaches where I want to. Yoko!